A senior Pentagon official has revealed that the United States Air Force, USAF, has officially commenced the production of the B-21 Raider, marking a significant milestone. This development follows the successful maiden flight of the stealth bomber a little over 2 months ago, highlighting the U.S. Air Force's accelerated production strategy for this aircraft. Undersecretary of Defense for Acquisition and Sustainment William LaPlante said in a statement, "Production of the B-21 Raider stealth bomber is moving forward. This past fall, based on the results of ground and flight tests and the team's mature plans for manufacturing, I gave the go-ahead to begin producing B-21s at a low rate." He added, "One of the key attributes of this program has been designing for production from the start and at scale to provide a credible deterrent to adversaries. If you don't produce and field to warfighters at scale, the capability doesn't really matter." Additionally, information regarding the contract award value and delivery dates is not currently accessible. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how B-21 Raider entering production gives a massive edge to the U.S. military. Let's get into the details. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Designed to succeed both the B-2 Spirit and the B-1 Lancer, the Raider is equipped with nuclear capabilities, is tailored for extended range missions, and incorporates stealth features to navigate through enemy air defenses effectively. This cutting-edge bomber will offer both survivability and long-range deep strike capabilities, serving as a deterrent against aggression and ensuring the protection of the United States, its allies, and its partners. B-21 is being developed under the Long Range Strike Bomber (LRSB) program. A request for proposal to develop the aircraft was issued in July 2014. On the 27th of October 2015, the U.S. Department of Defense awarded the development contract to Northrop Grumman. The B-21 designation, according to the U.S. Air Force, was chosen because the aircraft is the first new bomber of the 21st century. Well, the name Raider was chosen to represent the Doolittle Raiders, who flew a surprise attack during World War II. The Pentagon had linked the initiation of the program's low-rate initial production contract to the aircraft's inaugural flight, which occurred in November, and was succeeded by at least one additional test flight at Edwards Air Force Base. There are 5 to 6 B-21s known to be in various stages of production. Northrop Grumman said in a statement, "As shared by the U.S. Air Force, the Northrop Grumman B-21 Raider has entered low-rate initial production. Our team received the contract award after B-21 entered flight testing within the program baseline schedule. Our production representative test aircraft indicated readiness for production, achieving all flight performances and data requirements." The company added, "As the world's first sixth-generation aircraft, B-21 forms the backbone of the future for U.S. air power, delivering a new era of capability and flexibility through advanced integration of data, sensors, and weapons, and is rapidly upgradable to outpace evolving threats." While embroiled in a violent conflict with Ukraine, Russia has not halted the development of its next-generation stealth bomber, known by its codename PAC-DA, but the progress has slowed. This stealth bomber is supposed to replace Moscow's aging fleet of bombers like the Tupolev Tu-95 and Tupolev Tu-160, but the aircraft is still a long way off from being operational. Russian authorities anticipate the maiden flight of this aircraft to take place in around 2035. So Russia will be stuck with an inventory of non-stealthy bombers for at least a decade. Because of the vulnerabilities, these bombers have been used to fire long-range standoff missiles instead of getting deep inside Ukrainian territory. China is looking to replace its Xi'an H-6 bomber, which is a Tupolev Tu-16 produced under license in China. The country is working on a next-gen stealth bomber, codenamed the H-20. Indications point to the H-20 becoming the first Chinese military aircraft to possess intercontinental range capabilities. Anticipations were high for the aircraft to make its public debut before the conclusion of 2022, but this is not materialized. It's unlikely that the bomber will become operational anytime soon. The B-21 Raider is poised to become the cornerstone of the U.S. bomber fleet, gradually taking over from the B-1B Lancer and B-2 Spirit. It'll be part of the strategic deterrence, since it will be one leg of the U.S. nuclear triad. Air defense system capabilities have advanced rapidly in the last decade or so. SAM, or surface-to-air missile, can be deadly for even the most modern aircraft. These capabilities include advanced integrated air defense systems with long-range engagement capabilities, able to target and shoot down aircraft from hundreds of miles away. B-21 Raider is designed to mitigate this. U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin had said earlier, 50 years of advances in low observable technology have gone into this aircraft, and even the most sophisticated air defense systems will struggle to detect a B-21 in the sky. It's slightly smaller than B-2 but more nimble, has improved performance, can accommodate a more diversified and dynamic payload, and hosts advanced communications and sensor suite. The range of the B-21, Austin said, is unmatched by any other bomber. He added it won't need to be based in theater. It won't need logistical support to hold any target at risk. It's designed with an open systems architecture, enabling rapid insertion of mature technologies and allowing the aircraft to remain effective as threats evolve over time. The U.S. Air Force plans to buy at least 100 of the bombers and have them into service in the mid-2020s. So, while the U.S. is moving swiftly in the path of having a state-of-the-art bomber in significant numbers as part of its force, even near-peer rivals are far behind.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.